This week on Maker Update, a chalk bot to conquer your block, poetry across the phone lines, weaving cords, and a collection of great tips for wearable projects. Hello and welcome back to Maker Update, the show where we keep you up to date on all the cool things that makers are making. I'm Tyler Weingartner, and I hope you're all doing great, staying inspired, and making cool stuff. We've got a great show for you, so let's get started with the project of the week. We get our inspiration for projects from all kinds of places. A problem that needs solving, a thing we want to see in the world, and in the case of this sidewalk chalk robot by MrDadVs, sometimes it's just showing off to your neighbors. He wants to have the best sidewalk chalk on his street, and what better way to do that than to have a robot do it for you? Which is why he built AP McG, a robot designed to create sidewalk chalk art. There have been a handful of similar projects like this in the past, but there's quite a few elements of AP that make it unique, first among which is its design. Instead of being a gantry-style bot, which takes up a ton of space, it's a polar bot. On one end is a 15-pound weight, and the other is a single-axis gantry arm that rotates around a pivot point to deposit the chalk. Any art bot like this is essentially a CNC machine. And there are a ton of open source resources to get your own CNC project off the ground. But you only get so far with a polar bot like this one. But that design has a number of advantages. It's mechanically very simple, since it only has two motors. But it's also very compact for its overall size, since it can draw in an area twice as large as its length. But there's still a lot of problems to solve here. Like how to turn Cartesian G-code into polar G-code without turning everything into arcs and circles. Or the correct way to get the chalk down onto the pavement, the correct mixture of water and chalk powder, and the right pumps to get it there. And there's also this great tip for using light painting instead of markers or paint to debug the image mapping. It's a super fun video and a great project. More projects. From Fraens, we have this video on how they built this 3D printed cord knitting machine. This video is presented entirely without words, and I'll be the first to admit that I don't really know very much about the parts of a cord knitting machine. But this thing is so mesmerizing to watch that it almost doesn't matter. A single motor seems to be driving all the action through a number of different gearings. Most of the work is performed by this needle guide. A pair of cams on the top and bottom move the needles through this undulating pattern, while this yarn guide feeds the new yarn in from the top. The whole thing clamps to the edge of the table and the woven cord feeds out the bottom. They've designed a number of different needle guides for various patterns, and if you're interested in building your own, they make the files available, but for a price. Check out the links in the description to learn more about it. RootKid has created this phone that reads poetry to you. After seeing people interacting with an unplugged classic telephone in a public space, they got the idea to create one that folks could interact with. I learned about this project and the sidewalk chalk robot by a fan of the show, Simon Bunker. Thanks, Simon, for sending these in. The project works by reading you a poem when you lift the handset to your ear. He found a large repository of poetry, and some of it is read by their original author, and he used that. He also processed all the audio so they would sound like they came over the line of an old phone like this one. It's a cool creative project, and it gives me a few ideas of my own on what to do with old phones for projects.
Rain so dark I can't get through, train going by in a hurry.
Finally, we have this simple but fun home automation project by DIY Builder called Pandaa. And it just does one thing. Opens the blinds of his window. That might seem a little basic, but that simplicity is what makes this project special. There's no shortage of home automation platforms out there, but they don't do great things for your digital privacy. This project is based around an Arduino Nano, a stepper motor driver, and this voice recognition board that is completely offline. No voice tracking, no weird ads relating to the thing you were just talking about, just window blinds opening and closing at the command of your voice. As it should be. Now for some tips and tools from Macho Nacho Productions, I learned about the SD2 PSX, which is a smart memory card for the PlayStation 2 based on the Raspberry Pi Pico. A smart memory card is essentially a memory card with unlimited storage, thanks to its micro SD card slot. But this one in particular has a hidden feature. Because thanks to a software protocol on the smart card, it can launch custom software stored on the same micro SD card, making the possibility of homebrew PlayStation 2 games a lot more accessible. From snappiness, I learned about this project to create a waist-level viewfinder for digital cameras that don't have fold-out screens. This is a fun journey through cheap optics, since the only components needed here are a convex lens, a mirror, and a Fresnel lens to resolve and crop the final image. You might not need a waist-level viewfinder for your camera, but they look like they're a delight to use, and the knowledge of optics to be gained from this video is pretty impressive. Speaking of impressive knowledge, Becky Stern has a new video out that's a collection of her best tips for wearable projects for newbies and veterans alike. You'll get to learn her approach towards refining the scope of your project, the ins and outs of conductive thread, battery selection, strain relief, LED diffusion, and how to wash your wearable electronic projects once they've been worn out to a few too many parties and events. It's great stuff. And from Adafruit, they recently released a breakout for the TMC2209 stepper motor driver. This is the driver that has been powering most 3D printers for a while now, cherished because they're almost completely silent. But if you want to use them in your own projects, the documentation and library support for them isn't all that great. But with Adafruit producing this breakout, you're going to get some outstanding documentation and code examples for both CircuitPython and the Arduino IDE. If you're looking to add some precision motor control to your projects, check this one out. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, they have a new entry in their Another Teaching Moment series, and it's all about lithium-ion batteries. Lithium-ion batteries are rechargeable, high-power but low-weight batteries, making them ideal for portable applications. But they do have some considerations, such as their ideal temperature range or their need for a battery management system for the most optimal charging and maintenance of charge cycles. If you're looking to add portable power to your project, give this video a watch. All right, and that is going to do it for this week's show. I hope you enjoyed it. And a reminder that you can get more info about every single one of these projects by following the links down in the description. While you're there, leave us a comment, give us a thumbs up, and hit subscribe so you don't miss the next one. Huge thanks, as always, to DigiKey for making this show possible and to you for watching. Take care. We'll see you soon.